As a hockey player, we spend a lot of time in these kind of positions. And as you can see here, our hips are flexed, which means they get quite tight. So today I'm going to share with you 5 ways that you can unlock tight hips, which helps you to improve your performance and also will help you to reduce your risk of injury. For the Spider-Man lunge, we're going to basically start in a push-up position. Okay, and all we're going to do is we're going to bring our 1 foot forward, okay, and bring it back again. And you'll alternate. Okay, so you're getting a nice stretch here in the back leg. Okay, you're really extending that hip flexor. The key thing here is to make sure that you keep your chest up. Okay, and you can get a nice, you can drop that hip, make sure the back stays up nice and straight. And you just hold for a couple of seconds. You should feel some release and some tension there as well. Okay, what you can do is you can also add in a thoracic rotation. Okay, and that will also just open you up nicely as well. And you can always drop the hip a little bit, play around there as well to get some more release. So depending on how your body's feeling, okay, if you want to drop out a little bit, if you want to push that leg out a little bit, okay, if you want to get a bit more of the groin, you can go a little bit wider and you can get in the groin there as well. The frog is a great exercise for opening up your hips. So we want to position ourselves and all you want to do is open up the hips slightly to allow your butt to come all the way through. So just play around with the angles. Okay, and you want to rock back and forth. You might want to hold it for a couple of seconds. And you should find after a few reps, you should loosen up and you should be able to go further and lower. If you want to get a bit more of the groin, you can just open the legs a little bit wider and you can play with your angles. You can even jump a little bit to the left or to the right. And as you loosen up, you should feel that you should be able to go wider in the stance. Okay, so you just hold for a couple of seconds, come back out, and drive deeper again. For the 90-90 rotations, you want to set yourself up so that both legs are at about 90 degrees. Okay, so it should look almost like an S shape. All right, and we're going to be working now on internal and external rotation. Okay, so depending on how tight you are, might dictate the angle of your body. Okay, so if you want to lean back a little bit, and all we're going to do is we're going to rotate. When this one is currently internally rotated, this one's externally rotated, we're just going to flip so that they swap around. Okay, and this is really important as a hockey player. There's a lot of movement and agility type of movements, and we can get quite locked up in and around our hips, especially with internal and external rotation. So as you can see, we want to try and keep that 90 degree shape as we move, and try and keep your heels on the floor as well. Okay, so throughout the movement, keep the heels on the floor and you're just rotating, holding for a couple of seconds, 5 seconds max. You might get some nice stretches. If you can't quite get there, just work with the range that you can. Okay, and then as you get better, you can start to add some lifts, which is going to get a little bit of a contraction as well, which improves the range and your mobility. And also stability in these end ranges, which is also really important when we're trying to prevent injury. Okay, so do a few each side, and you should feel, after you've done a few, add the lifts, see how you can go with that. It's a really, really great exercise. It's one of my go-tos in part of the warm-up and also active recovery sessions as well. The couch stretch is also a really great exercise for releasing not just the quad, but through the hip flexors. So what you want to do is you want to get your knee almost perpendicular to the ground, in line with as close to a wall, a bench, a sofa. Okay, and you want to just get the foot rested, get your knee as far back to the wall as you can. Okay, and in this front leg, you can just lean forward, feel where you can feel it. Okay, and if it's as it eases, you can start to come a bit more upright. Okay, you can also move in and out of it. Typically, you want to do this and you want to stretch a little bit more when you're warmer. So particularly after sessions, the end of sessions, or in your active recovery sessions once you've got moving a little bit, but it is a nice little exercise just to open up those hips as well. The goal is to be able to come completely upright. Okay, so we really are then pushing this hip forward. Okay, so push the hip forward, try and come upright. So when we're trying to release our hips, it's important to not just do some static stretches, but to also add in some dynamic movements. Okay, so leg swings are one of my go-to favorite exercises, so that we release through movement. Okay, so you might start a little bit conservative initially, but as you release, you can start to go a little bit further. So we're getting a nice hip extension as we come back. Okay, so keep nice and stable throughout the movement, and you're focusing here on hip. Okay, so you can go leg swings forward and back. You can also add in inside, outside. Okay, so you're going to get a bit more of the groin. Just hold on to something or someone. Keep your balance so that you can really focus on the movement. Opening up, and again, as you release, you can start to push it a little bit further. And it's a great one to release the hips, like I said, through dynamic movement. So you're not just relying on static stretching. Also, by adding in some movements and some contractions, you can also get some nice release in the hips. If you're a hockey player over 35 looking for ways to improve and take your game to the next level, check out my free training I put together called The 4 Ways to Modernize Your Game. You can find the link in the description or head to my bio to get instant access.